LOSC, define forward contract, futures contract, options which include calls and puts, swaps, credit derivatives, and compare their basic characteristics. Now this is pretty big LOS, many things which we need to understand, we have to understand in this LOS. In this video, we will only focus on forward contract. We will discuss what is forward contract and what are the characteristics of forward contract. So let's start with understanding the definition of forward contract. Now, forward contract is a bilateral contract. Now here the word bilateral basically means between two parties. So forward contract is a bilateral contract in which price of an asset is decided today, quantity is decided today, and settlement will take place in future. Now here the word today basically means on the day when contract is designed. So at that time, price, quantity will be decided and settlement will take place in future. Let's understand with the help of example. Now imagine there is one farmer who wants to sell 1000 dozens of mangoes. On the other hand, we have one merchant who wants to purchase 1000 dozens of mangoes. So here farmer will be called as seller as he needs to sell mangoes, and merchant will be called as buyer as he needs to buy mangoes. So these are the two parties involved in the contract. Now the problem is both farmer and merchant do not know what will be the price of mangoes when season of mangoes will arrive. So today we can say there is price uncertainty, because farmer do not know how much price he will receive for 1000 dozens of mangoes, and merchant also do not know how much price he has to pay 1000 dozens of mangoes when season will arrive. So what these two parties can do to remove this price uncertainty or to eliminate this price uncertainty, these parties can enter into a contract where farmer will promise to a merchant that I will sell 1000 dozens of mangoes to you, let's say at rupees 2 lakhs, and merchant will promise, okay, I will purchase 1000 dozens of mangoes from you at rupees 2 lakhs. So this rupees 2 lakh is called as contract price. So as you can see in this example, two parties are involved, farmer, merchant, one is seller, one is buyer. That's why we have a word in the definition, bilateral contract. Price is decided today, rupees 2 lakhs in this example. Quantity is also decided today, 10,000 dozens of mangoes. Settlement will happen in future. So both the parties will decide one settlement date based on their convenience. Now in LOSA, we have discussed that forward contract is a customized contract. Now here customization basically means you can see price, quantity, and settlement date. All these three things are decided by farmer and merchant in this example based on their mutual convenience. So as you can see, the price is 2 lakhs. How this price is arrived? Based on their mutual convenience. Quantity is 1000 dozen. Again, how this quantity came? Based on their mutual convenience. When the settlement will happen? Settlement will happen in future date. One date they will decide, again based on their mutual convenience. So terms and conditions of a contract is decided by parties involved. That's why forward contract is known as customized contract. Now let's understand the features of forward contract. Now on settlement date, you know, one thing, two things can happen. Number one, price of mangoes can be more than rupees 2 lakhs, or price of mangoes can be less than rupees 2 lakhs. Let's understand the situation number one. Let's say on settlement date, price of mangoes is ₹2,50,000. Now, as per terms of the contract, merchant has right to buy mangoes at ₹2 lakhs, because merchant and farmer, they both have entered into a contract. Merchant has promised to purchase mangoes for ₹2 lakhs, and farmer has promised that he will sell mangoes for ₹2 lakhs, irrespective whatever the price is on settlement date. So price can be either more than contract price on settlement date, or price can be below the contract price on the settlement date. So when price is more than contract price, so in this case, party with long position will have a positive value. So in this case, merchant is said to have a long position. Now the word long stands for buyer position, and farmer is said to have a short position. So here the word short stands for sell position. So remember this point: when settlement price is more than contract price, party with long position will have a positive value. So in this case, you can see merchant is getting a benefit of ₹50,000, because merchant has a right to buy mangoes worth ₹2,50,000 for ₹2 lakhs. So in this case, we can say the merchant is hedged. Second scenario, let's say if price of mangoes is ₹1,50,000, that is below contract price. Now in this case, farmer has a right to sell at ₹2 lakhs, and merchant has obligation to buy at ₹2 lakhs. So in this case, we can say the seller or farmer is hedged. So basically, you need to understand that when settlement price is more than contract price, buyer or party with long position will have a positive value, and party with short position will have a negative value. And if settlement price is less than contract price, party with short position will have a positive value, and party with long position will have a negative value. Next feature is parties enter in forward contract either to speculate or to do hedging. So there are the two reasons why basically parties entered into a forward contract. Number one, either to speculate. Number two, or to do hedging. But more often, a party seeks to enter into a forward contract to hedge an existing exposure. As we discussed in this example, farmer and merchant, they basically entered to hedge their existing exposures, not to speculate the prices. Feature three, types of asset involved in forward contract. So there are two kinds of asset involved in forward contract. Number one, physical asset. Now here, physical asset means commodity. Number two, financial asset. So when I'm saying financial asset, it includes equities and bonds. So the example which we discussed here of mangoes, it comes under physical asset. Number four, typically neither party to the contract makes a payment at the initiation. So the day on which contract is designed, no party makes payment to each other. The payment basically happen on settlement date. So on settlement date, whatever the price of underlying asset is at that time, it will be called settlement price. So as we discussed earlier, when settlement price is greater than contract price, long position will have a positive value. That means buyer will have a positive value, seller will have a negative value. And if settlement price is less than contract price, in this case, short position will have a positive value and long position will have a negative value. Now, when it comes to settlement, you need to understand the different types of settlement. So two types of settlements are available. One is known as physical settlement, other is known as cash settlement. Now in physical settlement, short will deliver the underlying asset to the long. So continuing with our example of farmer and merchant, So if it is a physical settlement, farmer has to deliver mangoes to the merchant and merchant has to purchase those mangoes from farmer. So this is the known as physical settlement. Now let's understand what is cash settlement. Under cash settlement, one party pay cash to the other when contract expire, that is on settlement date, based on difference between the contract price and the market price of the underlying asset on the settlement date. So let's say if contract price is 2 lakh and market price of underlying asset on the settlement date is 2,50,000. So in this case, long party, okay, farm merchant in our example, long party will receive rupees 50,000 from short party. So merchant is plus 50,000, farmer is minus 50,000. So farmer has to pay 50,000 to the merchant. So this is the meaning of cash settlement. On the other hand, if contract price is 2 lakh and market price on the settlement date is 1,50,000, now here short, that is farmer, will receive rupees 50,000 from merchant, that is from long party. One important note, cash settled forward contract are also known as contract for difference, CFD, or non-deliverable forwards, NFDs.